H.C. Verma, Chapter 10, Question Number 62. Two small balls A and B, each of mass m, are joined rigidly by a light horizontal rod of length L. The rod is clamped at the center in such a way that it can rotate freely about a vertical axis through its center. The system is rotated with an angular speed omega about the axis. A particle P of mass m kept at rest sticks to the ball A as the ball collides with it. Find the new angular speed of the rod. Since there is no external torque acting on the system, the angular momentum of the system must be conserved. As the system is in pure rotation, both before and after collision, the angular momentum of the system is moment of inertia into angular speed. If you want to know how to write angular momentum in different cases, you should watch our video on angular momentum. The link for the video is shown on the screen and given in the descriptions below. Now, since the particle and the balls are small, they can be considered point masses. But to show the motion better, we have exaggerated their sizes in the animation. In case of point mass, the moment of inertia is given by mr square, where m is the mass and r is the distance of the body from the axis. Also, since before collision only the balls are moving, for initial angular momentum we need only the moment of inertia of the balls. Thus, the initial moment of inertia is 2 into m into l by 2 whole square. Simplifying, we get ml square by 2. Multiplying moment of inertia with initial angular speed, we get the initial angular momentum. Thus, initial angular momentum of the system is ml square by 2 into omega. Since after the collision, the particle and both the balls are moving, the moment of inertia of the system is 3 into m into l by 2 whole square, or 3 ml square by 4. If the final angular speed be omega dash, then final angular momentum is equal to 3 by 4 ml square into omega dash. This final angular momentum must be equal to the initial angular momentum. Thus, 3 by 4 ml square into omega dash must be equal to half ml square into omega. Simplifying, we get omega dash is equal to 2 by 3 omega. This is our answer. In order to request solution to any question from H.C. Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in the comments below. You might like to watch other solutions of this chapter. The link for the playlist is shown on the screen. You may also like to watch our videos on theories, tools and techniques of physics. The playlist is shown on the screen. Subscribe the channel and like our Facebook page for latest updates. Thank you for watching.